Calculating lens distortion can have a big impact on the quality of your solve, but transferring this lens data to other applications can sometimes seem daunting. Different software packages have different requirements, and realizing you worked on the wrong version way down your pipeline can be really frustrating. But once you wrap your head around it, the lens workflows inside of SynthEyes are really powerful. I'm Christoph Zapletal for Boris Effects, and in this video, I want to take you onto a deep dive into the lens workflows offered in SynthEyes. Every physical camera has got some degree of lens distortion. Sometimes it's negligible, sometimes it's hard to overlook. CG cameras, on the other hand, are the one thing that a real lens never can be: physically perfect. So in any match-moving scenario, you need to take lens distortion into account, as uncalculated lens distortion will make it harder for SynthEyes to solve its 2D trackers to the correct position in 3D space. SynthEyes has got a lot of ways to calculate lens distortion, and we do have some great tutorials on that topic. But this is not what this tutorial is about. We are instead going to talk about how to correctly remove or apply lens distortion data, both for your workflow as well as when exporting to different applications. This is the shot I want to work on. I already solved it and let SynthEyes also calculate its lens distortion using the radial fourth order model. I can tell you that this shot has got quite some lens distortion, even if we don't see it at first glance. But let's switch to the lens room where we can see the lens grid overlay. That is quite some barrel distortion. If you want to see the distortion removed instead of the grid being distorted, just switch to the perspective view and zoom out a little bit. There we can see how much the edges need to be pushed out of our format to remove the distortion. Now I want to put two CG cars onto this rooftop using a match move camera and some rough reference geo from SynthEyes. I want to use Blender for lighting, shading and rendering my CG assets, and Nuke for final compositing. Let's open up the lens workflow window. We see two workflows presented to us: Undistorted 1 and Redistorted 2. Your first inclination might be to say, let's go with Undistorted. That is what I want, an undistorted image to use in my CG app. Okay, let's go down that route. We apply the Undistorted and we immediately see changes in our perspective view. The lens distortion is removed and down in our time bar, our image sequence is recaching. Why? We didn't change the footage. No. But once you run the lens workflow, SynthEyes is sending the lens distortion value to the image pre-processing panel. We can see that if we call up the panel by hitting P on the keyboard. If we use a save-to-sequence exporter, we can write this out as a PNG sequence and use this as a backplate for Blender. I will also export an Alembic and a Nuke script from this scene. The Alembic will include all my proxy geometry and my camera. If I bring those into Blender, I've got a great base for setting up our cars on the rooftop. All that works like a charm. The problems will start to show up once you get into compositing. Let's open up the Nuke script where we will find the lens distortion node. If we bring in our CG from Blender and merge it on top of our footage, we can clearly see that the distortion is missing. That is why we do get some drifting towards the edges. So let's pick up the lens distortion node that SynthEyes exported into the Nuke script, switch it to Redistort, and apply it to our CG from Blender. Uh-oh. The CG now sits in place, but take a look at the edges. On the bottom edge, our sports car is cut off, and it is even more visible with the great sedan. So what went wrong? Our initial clip was UHD. When we applied the undistorted workflow, SynthEyes assumed you wanted to deliver an undistorted imagery as your final product. There are use cases for this, but if you're working in film and video, often lens characteristics, like distortion, are a creative choice that are meant to be retained. Hence you want to deliver a redistorted image. This is really important in order to understand SynthEyes nomenclature here. The undistorted and redistorted names refer to your final delivery down your VFX pipeline. In our example, our original footage is shot at UHD resolution. As we can't work on the distorted image in our CG application, we actually need to work on an undistorted plate that is larger than the original UHD format in order to accommodate all the pixels that then can be properly redistorted to make up a UHD image without the edges being cut off. With that in mind, let's rewind a little bit and explore the Redistorted 2 workflow. So this is the state of my shot from the beginning of this video. We now run the Redistorted 2 workflow instead. We can once again see a change in our perspective view. Our image is undistorted, but this time we see black edges added to our image. That way, the barrel distortion can be removed, but all the pixels in the image can actually be retained. Nothing is cut off. If we render out this sequence, we can notice one more thing about our new undistorted file sequence. It is larger. Instead of keeping the original UHD resolution that my shot had when I started, this is now 4,224 times 2,376 pixels. These couple of percent more canvas actually enable us to render our CG big enough to have enough detail to reapply the original camera distortion inside of Nuke without anything being cut off. On a side note, SynthEyes allows you to add additional margin here. This can become really handy if the shot you match moved on is about to be reframed or extended. With all that out of the way, we can now also explain the numbers in the brackets next to each workflow. These numbers indicate the number of undistortion redistortion passes in your workflow. So the undistorted one workflow consists of a single undistortion pass, while the redistorted two workflow consists of two passes, one for the undistortion, one for the redistortion. One more important thing to note. Switching back and forth between different lens workflows, changing the image canvas resolution, etc., can potentially mess up your scene. So that is the perfect opportunity to highlight the undo earlier run option. It is basically a lens workflow specific undo. So if you're unsure what you did, you can use this option to get back to your pre-lens workflow state. This way of applying the lens workflow offers huge flexibility and lets you basically adapt the way you work with your scene at any stage of your match moving process. But, and this is a big but, it can be destructive. As you might have realized by now, the changes applied in the lens workflow panel are persistent to your scene. Let's take a look at our scenario. In order to create the CG cars in Blender and then composite them back onto the original plate inside of Nuke, we do need a couple of things from SynthEyes. An undistorted image sequence with overscan as a backdrop for our Blender scene. An Alembic file that has got the same characteristics. A Nuke scene that includes undistort and redistort nodes or SD maps with the same lens characteristics and overscan. And to round things off, a reference movie where the proxy geo we created in SynthEyes is embedded with proper distortion applied. That might get confusing quickly using the method I've shown you up until now. But as the lens workflow is also integrated into the export options, we can apply them there temporarily, just for a specific export. That means we can undistort and apply margins or crops to our delight. Any changes we made will be removed immediately after the export is finished. So how does this work? Let's start with exporting an undistorted PNG sequence of our footage to use as a backdrop in Blender. But this time, I'm not going to apply any lens workflow before exporting. Instead, I'm going straight to the Save to Sequence exporter. In the pop-up menu, we can then choose the lens workflow we want to apply. I'm going to go with Redistorted 2. If you need access to the additional options like setting up a margin, those are hidden in the three dots menu. Let's export our sequence. Once that is done, we can work on our scene like before, without having to manually undo our redistort workflow, as this was only applied temporarily for this export. So now we can do the same thing for all the other exports we still have to do. But here's a bonus tip for you. You can set up different lens workflow settings in the multi-exporter. That is especially handy if you've got a predefined workflow setup and don't want to have to manually configure each and every export. I'm going to set up the four exports redefined, starting once again with the undistorted PNG sequence for Blender. The export options are exactly the same as with the traditional export, the only difference being that the export button changes to Settings OK, as we will only export once our multi-export preset is finished. I can also use filename tags to create an identical folder structure on every shot, even if they are in different projects or locations. That way you can configure your own shopping list for SynthEyes that you can call up every time you're ready to export. If you need to change anything, just hit the little play button here and modify your export settings. Just don't forget to save your preset. That way, you can set up an individual preset for all lens distortion models you're frequently using. As I've calculated the lens distortion in this shot with the radial fourth order advanced lens distortion model, I will name it accordingly. Before we close out this tutorial, let's quickly see our exports in action. This is the Blender scene with the overscan image as a background. As you can see, everything lines up nicely. And Blender renders out an overscan image that I can then redistort in Nuke from its overscan resolution back to UHD. But now I've got no funny edge out effects when my cars meet the edge of the screen. The lens workflow in SynthEyes should take care of all the various workflow scenarios you might face. I would suggest playing around with these exports to your CG and compositing applications of choice, just to foolproof your workflow before starting any render heavy work. If you've got any questions about the lens workflow, hit us up in the comments below or visit our Discord, link is in the description. For tutorials on how to calculate lens distortion and much more, visit us at boriseffects.com, where you can also sign up for a free SynthEyes trial. I'm Christoph Zapletal for Boris Effects, and I will see you in another video.